Because it's important to note that 95% of this stuff can be accounted for and has been accounted for, but the fact that they were pulling from that 95% and they ignored the other 5 means that the entire report led to this idea that this field of ufology could not be integrated with mainstream science. It's a big reason why I made this group in the first place, because I want to try and get the information out there and help people understand, at least at a young age, I mean, sort of young, I really do think that this is something that can be integrated and will be in the future integrated into mainstream science, because there's a lot of serious research that goes into it. You look at what MUFON do, they treat everything that they, every encounter they go to is like a crime scene, and they gather evidence and they talk to witnesses. The psychologists in the field that deal with the people that have had traumatic experiences, and it really fucks up their life if they've been abducted by aliens and think that they've been sexually abused or whatever by aliens, because whether it's real or not, it's real to them. And that's what's important to know, is because it doesn't matter whether or not the aliens came from outer space or they came from your imagination, because it affects so many people mentally and consequently physically, because if they have really mental problems, that leads to their physical health. It's something that needs to be treated seriously, which it's not, because of Condon's report, which enters right directly into Project Blue Book. Project Blue Book was the third installment of the government's attempt to try and make the public happy. That was all it was about, is try and make the public happy, do something that they would feel good about. Scientists would like it, people would like it, everyone would say, okay, yeah, this is the definitive proof. This is the UFO Bible that I have here, and it has everything, all the facts, it's well documented. That was what Project Blue Book was supposed to be. Now, it ran for a 20-year period. It started in 1951, it was the third one. It came directly after Project Grudge. Just a few years there. And it concluded in December of 1969 with the release of the Condon Report. The Condon Report was released in 1968, and it has been cited as the authoritative resource for anything and everything UFOs, according to the government. Well, what is the Condon Report? Well, the Condon Report is a 965-page document of bullshit. That's basically what it is. Let's just start with that. And it's really unfortunate, I'm going to get into it. This is really where I get to rip it apart, because the entire premise is just extremely biased, and you'll see exactly why. But the unfortunate thing is people that don't know the history behind the Condon Report, they don't know the history behind the Blue Book, and that it was preceded by two other clandestine projects, people such as Bill Nye, this is the skeptic's go-to resource. Every time Bill Nye talks about UFOs, he generally likes to mention things about the Condon Report and how the government actually did the study and it was scientific and they came to these conclusions, but it's basically, in a sense, all false. Now, the report was authored, some would say exclusively, by Edward Condon himself at the expense of his entire research team, because it has... It has this authoritative statement right from the start that UFOs are complete bogus, and it doesn't take any leaps or bounds to incorporate alternative views, and it's actually not very scientific at all. Now, if you actually want to have a look at some of what the document entails, I have a link provided here. So I'll link to the Condon Report there. Now, basically, Condon Report makes two premises. The first one says that there is no scientific evidence to support the conclusion that UFOs are anything more than a hoax or some type of phenomena of the mind, hallucinations, and furthermore, that the whole thing the government wasn't concerned about was, are they a threat? That was what they were really concerned about. Was there a threat? And the answer that they came to was no. And it's okay if that's the conclusion they come to on an unbiased opinion. It's premise two that I have an issue with. It's the whole reason that I did write the article in the first place, because premise two goes on to say, in addition to that, there will be no further value gained from any future study to ever be done in this field. It's the single worst thing that has ever happened to the field of ufology, because it basically says that we've done this study, and these are our conclusions, and therefore nobody should ever touch this ever again. And that's absolutely insane, because if you're dealing with any type of actual, real scientific study, you don't just say that these are my conclusions and therefore nobody should ever touch it again. I mean, people even today aren't even sure about things that Einstein said. There's all this talk about, oh, well, maybe he was wrong here, maybe he was only half right there. So just because you do a study and it's very conclusive and it's very supported, doesn't mean that it's definitive. And that's really what they tried to hand the Condon report off as. It was basically the UFO Bible. It was going to be the 100% truth and definitive answer. But as they said, it was completely biased from the start. And it's premise two that I have the issue with, because it basically, as they said, set the whole field of ufology back decades, because nobody would touch this ever, and nobody has touched it in any legitimacy ever since. And it made things like MUFON and what they do, and other organizations that have been popping up on their own, they have to be privately funded. The government won't touch this. The scientific community won't touch this, because they say, well, the government did this report. Well, the government started the report. That's what they did. They didn't finish the report, but they started it. It was this whole botched up mess, and in the end, Condon ended up authoring this document, and it has other people's names on it. And when you look specifically at the evidence in it, some of the best UFO cases that have been recorded over the time, such as the alien abduction case of Betty and Barney Hill, I did a search through the document. There was only a single line in there even briefly mentioning it. And so most of the best cases that they had from over 20,000 cases they could pull from, and there's only about 120 in total that actually appear in the 965-page document, and most of them are not from the really good stuff. Now, this is probably the most important slide that I've done up for the entire lecture series, and that's because of what it entails. When you're looking at the Condon report from a serious standpoint, you find that the whole thing was poisoned from the start. It was a contract that was signed in 1966, and it basically, from that date, sealed the fate of Blue Book. It was a Blue Book itself was intended to be unbiased, but it's important to look at why was it done at the University of Colorado in the first place. It was because they had a serious lack of funding in their scientific department, and because they were going to go belly up. They were facing this situation in which if they didn't get any more funding for their scientific department at this university, they would have to pull all scientific research and programs, and they'd have to fire people, and there'd be lost opportunities for students, and it would just be a whole mess. Meanwhile, on the other hand, the government was dealing with this project that they've been running for the last 18, 17 years. The public is really pushing them to give it to the scientific community. That's what we want. We don't want the military, we don't want the Air Force, we don't want you guys looking at this stuff. We want the scientific community. So on one hand, you have an institution that has a failing science department because they have a lack of funding. On the other hand, you have a government that can't find a reputable institution to touch this. Every place they went and looked for, everyone laughed at them, they thought it was crazy. Nobody would touch this because nobody wanted to have their name attached to it. But because of the failing science department at the University of Colorado, that's why they got it. Because they realized that it was basically for their survival. If they were going to keep their jobs, if they were going to keep the science department alive, they needed this $500,000 grant from the government. And the thing is, they were going to get this money regardless of what conclusions they came to. So the entire purpose of Condon's committee very quickly from the start became to get it done as fast as possible and get paid, and it didn't matter what they actually did, and objectivity and reason can go flying out the window because all we need is the money so we can get back to our other research. As a result of that, many of the people that were initially assigned to work on this team, they left and they quit, and there was people that were fired. So did J. Allen Hynek. He was one of the scientific coordinators that was assigned to the Condon's committee. And I don't think any ufologist has ever really said this, but I think it's the credit that he really deserve. This man is essentially speaking the father of ufology, at least in the modern sense as we know it now, and as it pertains to things like MUFON's work and what I'm trying to hope to accomplish here. Basically, all of this seriousness about it is because of people like J. Allen Hynek, and I think that's something that he should get due credit for as being the father of ufology. Initially, he was actually a skeptic, although his close encounter with Condon is one of the many things that helped to solidify his belief that there was actually something of subjective value to the phenomena. And in fact, it's been said that as early as 1953, he had a change of opinion regarding UFOs when he wrote an article about them to the Optics Society of America. And in addition, I covered last week in the abduction phenomenon, I covered the chart. It's actually his work that he created, the close encounters of the first kind, second kind, that goes up third, fourth kind. That's his work. And to try and give this idea that premise one can hold. You can keep premise one, it'll be a document, and it is a document that discredits UFOs, that's its intent. Premise two doesn't hold any water, because it says that nobody doing any scientific research in the future can come to a serious conclusion. And this is 1968, and people have believed this lie of premise two ever since. This is 2017, and for the most people, you see in the chart I showed you in the first lecture of the belief in UFOs and aliens and how it's risen over the years. It's this weird pseudoscientific thing where everyone believes in it, but nobody will talk about it. If you kind of know what that means. It's like everybody has it, like, yeah, oh yeah, I believe aliens exist somewhere out there. But nobody really wants to talk about that, and I think that's a real shame.